Ford has just announced 2022 Mustang Mach-E prices and features, and it expects to triple its output to 200,000 by 2023. And that is big news for Ford. Hello, my friends. My name is Sam Evans. Welcome to the Electric Viking. Fantastic to have you here on the channel. I want to say a big welcome to all the new subscribers over the past month. I think there's been about 20,000 of you. Welcome to the channel. Make sure you check out some of the 700 plus videos we've created over the last 6 months. Seriously, we don't sit around here on this channel. Now, I want to say a big thank you, big shout out to supporters of the channel on Patreon. I'll put a link in the description below if you want to join those supporters and support the electric revolution, which is what this channel is all about. Now, Ford, they are really kicking some goals lately. Within the last few hours, The Electric has reported that Ford CEO Jim Farley took to Twitter to announce a 3x increase in Mustang Mach-E production. The company also alerted dealers that modest price increases and new packages would be coming for 2022 models. Now, the California Route 1 Edition also got a meaningful range bump. So, if that one's priced a little bit higher, then I can understand that if you're getting more range. Now, the company has delayed a much-anticipated Explorer EV, which is a bit of a bummer. We were first alerted to the Mustang Mach-E price increases last week when a dealer bulletin was sent around from Ford dealers noting the price increases, which amount to $1,000 to $2,000 per model and up to $3,000 with options. Now, as I've reported in the past, these prices are ridiculous. That's one of the reasons why some buyers have not bought Mustang Mach-Es and bought Tesla vehicles instead, because they feel like they're getting screwed over by Ford dealers. This is not just me saying this. This is lots of people online saying they've had experiences of Ford dealers trying to charge them well over sticker price for the Mustang Mach-E. Now, some of these buyers have turned to Ford. They've contacted Ford head office directly, and Ford head office just say, well, too bad. That's the way it is. Nothing you can do about it. In fact, one executive at Ford actually said, just buy a Tesla. Seriously, that's what they told them. Just buy a Tesla. Now, I really hope that Ford gets on top of this and just rein in your dealers. Just tell them, guys, you're ruining the party for us here. This is a party. We can sell a lot of these cars. People want the Mustang Mach-E. It's a fantastic car. Please do the right thing by customers. Now, hopefully Ford dealers do the right thing by customers, because really sending them away is not the right thing to do. Now, these price increases are notable, not because of how large they are, but because of how small they are. Other EV makers have been raising prices much more abruptly throughout the year, as the pandemic has caused chip shortages and inflation. Now, while this is true, at the same time, if you look at the prices of electric cars in China, yeah, I mean, you know, the Tesla Model 3, the Model Y, the Mustang Mach-E, all these cars for sale in America, they're pretty expensive compared to what you can get electric cars for in China. I mean, that's the facts, right? In China, there are so many electric car manufacturers that companies are not having to say, we're raising our prices, we're raising our prices. But you know what? Maybe this actually comes down partly to the fact that inflation is so crazy in the last few months in America. What's going on, guys? Let me know in the comments. What's going on? This is weird. What's inflation? Are you printing too many dollars? I don't know. Maybe this is coming around. I mean, America does like to print money. Now, retail price increases effective as of December the 8th, 2021. So I'm sorry you've missed out if you're seeing this video now on not getting these price increases, unless you've got a nice friendly dealer and he's willing to do a good price for you. The Mach-E Select, $1,000 increase. The Mach-E California Route 1, $2,000 increase. The Mach-E Premium, $1,000 increase. The Mach-E GT, $2,000 increase. The 60P GT Performance Package, $1,000 increase. And the 997-99U Extended Range Battery, $1,000 increase. So they are pretty modest increases. But like I said before, if this was the actual price, like if this was the price, you just paid the price, then what I'm saying, I could kind of, it would make sense, right? But the fact is, we have no idea which dealer you go to, what real price you're actually going to be charged, or what real price they're actually going to try to charge you, at least anyway. Now, good news. There is some good news. Well, other than the fact that they're going to triple actual production of this car, that's fantastic news. There are some updates to the Mustang Mach-E, the 2022 model, including the 2022 Mustang Mach-E is now available for order on Ford.com, starting at $44,000, not including a $7,500 federal tax credit. Why has no one noticed this? Ford is saying you can order it on Ford.com starting at $43,995. This seems to me as though Ford is saying you can buy it online. This is big news. I mean, I thought this was illegal in many states in America. Are they saying that you can do this in Texas? Can you buy it online in Texas? Can you go around the dealer? Or is there the fact that they have an actual dealer in Texas, or lots of dealers in Texas, heaps of them, and then you'd pick the vehicle up in from the dealer mean that that's fine? That's maybe it does. But anyway, the big news here is this seems to mean that you can order it online at the sticker price. And if that's the case, wow, this is huge news for Ford. Massive. Now, the Mustang Mach-E California Route 1 has an increased EPA estimated range of 314 miles, up from 305, 9-mile increase. Not a lot, but it's good, better than nothing. And it's now available with all-wheel drive and get standard heated seats and a steering wheel. Heated steering wheel, not just a steering wheel thrown. In the 2022 model year, Ice White Edition appearance package is available on Mach-E Premium. Black painted roof is now standard on Mustang Mach-E GT and GT Performance Edition. I'm not into these black roofs. Color contrast thing. Are you? I reckon they look weird. Anyway, Grabber Blue and Cyber Orange are now available on all trims, and Ice Blue Silver Metallic is new to the 2022 model year for the Mustang Mach-E. Ford CEO took to Twitter to highlight the increased output for the Mustang Mach-E's from the plant in Mexico. Yeah, not even made in America. Yeah, come on, Ford. Let's do it in America. Come on, guys. Come on. It's hard to produce Mustang Mach-E's fast enough to meet the incredible demand, but we are sure going to try. Come on, you Mexicans, work harder. Sorry. So starting in 2022, we are increasing production and expect to reach 200,000 units per year for North America and Europe by 2023. That's three times our 2021 output. So Jim Farley has now become like a different version of Elon Musk. He likes to tweet things. I think this is a smart move. Good idea. Now, Ford announced yesterday that they were closing down the F-150 Lightning reservation system because it had reached 200,000 and they were able to keep up with demand. And they've delayed their Explorer EV Lincoln Navigator for 1 year to 2024, as the Mexican factory output would entirely be taken up by the Mach-E. So that's the kind of bad news here to this situation. Bad news, I guess, of Ford kind of deciding a little bit late that they were going to go all in on electrification. However, this is the good news. The Ford picture of EVs becoming very important for the company is starting to come together. The company said it wants to produce 600,000 electric vehicles per year by 2023. That's impressive. Now they're saying that one third or 33% of all of those vehicles, of those 600,000, will be Mustang Mach-E's. Now, this is what Ford said. We have unprecedented demand for Mustang Mach-E, and we are going to scale production quickly to meet that demand. We are now planning to utilize the entire Mexican starting in 2022 and expect to reach 200,000 units per year by 2023. Our goal is to become the clear number two electric vehicle maker in North America within the next couple of years and then challenge for number one, as the huge investments we are making in EV and battery manufacturing come on stream and we rapidly expand our EV lineup. Rapidly scaling production of Mustang Mach-E supports our plan. So they are saying one thing here that makes sense. They're trying to become number two in America. Yeah, that's achievable. Absolutely. That's realistic. And then saying challenge for number one. I like that they're not using this wacky language that Mary Barra has been saying, claiming they're already number one now. I mean, what? Serious? So Ford, in my view, are being very realistic. They're setting big goals and trying to achieve them. I really like what they're doing. But all of this aside, big news here. They're going to make 600,000 EVs in 2023. 200,000 of those will be Mustang Mach-E's. And it looks as though you might be able to order them online at a price that Ford is advertising and not pay more than the sticker. So mostly, this is good news from Ford. Thanks for the good news, Ford. Great to hear this stuff. I like it. Thanks for watching the channel. Look forward to seeing you again on the next one. Bye-bye.